All right, so we're going to make a program to control rack and pinion steering, and that needs to be able to turn a motor on when you press on the infrared controller, and it needs to only turn that motor a certain number of degrees, and then if you're not pressing on the controller, it needs to center that motor. So we're going to start with a couple of loops, and go ahead and drop one loop inside of another loop. And then the next thing that we're going to need is a switch. And this switch is going to be looking at our motor rotation. And we want to see that the motor has turned less than a certain number of degrees. And that's going to prevent it from going too far. And we're going to want this to be less than. And I'm going to go ahead and set this to 35. And you're probably going to want to play with these numbers because every steering is going to be a little different. Now we're going to need another switch up here at the top. And this switch is going to look at the remote control infrared. Well, it's going to look at the infrared sensor. And we're going to set it to compare and remote so that it will detect if we're pressing some of these buttons. Now, this right here, this tab is what channel you're on, and this one is the buttons you're going to press, and we're going to go ahead and set this to this top left-hand button, and we also want this motor to turn on in combination with the right-hand buttons, so we're going to select 1, 5, and 6, and now we need a motor to go up here, and we're going to build our steering off of the medium motor, and so we'll drop that into the top of this switch. So that if any of those buttons that we selected are pressed, it's going to route up here to the top, and it's going to turn this motor on for a certain number of degrees. We're going to set this for on for degrees, and we're going to turn this down. We don't want it to move too violently, and we'll go ahead and set this for 35 also, and then we're going to set this here for negative 35 degrees. And that should turn our motor on, not too fast, and it should turn at negative 35 degrees. And I'm sorry, that's incorrect. This should be positive 35 degrees right here. And now we need a switch that's going to do the exact opposite of this. So we're just going to cut and paste, or copy and paste this whole switch right here. So copy and paste the whole switch, and we'll drop that in right behind that first switch in the first loop. And now we need to reverse some of these values. So this is going to be greater than, and this is going to be minus 35, and this is going to be the opposite set of buttons. So it's the bottom button right here on the left, and then also right-hand buttons in combination with that. So we got 2, 7, and 8 right there. And now we want this to turn negative 35 degrees. All right, so that should turn our motors on when we press the infrared controller. And now what we need is something to make the motors center themselves. So we're going to have this loop end if we're and on the infrared sensor here, and we're going to go to compare and remote, and we're just going to look for no buttons pressed. And now that'll end the loop if we're not pressing any buttons. And right behind that, in the next loop, we're going to need a switch. And this switch is going to look at the motor rotation, because it's going to be correcting our motor back to the center. So we're going to look for degrees. And we're going to go ahead and set this to less than, and we're going to set this to 10, sorry, minus 10. And then we're going to need a motor for that to turn on, and we're going to grab that medium motor, and we're going to set this on 4 degrees. And We're going to set this to 5 degrees. On for degrees, 5 degrees. All right. So that'll correct our motor if it's off by more than negative 10 degrees, 5 degrees at a time, slowly pulling it back to the center. Well, not very slow, but correcting it in increments. And now we're going to need another one that does the exact opposite of that. So we're going to copy and paste that. And drop it in right behind that other switch. And we need to reverse these values here. So this is going to be greater than, and this is going to be 10, and this is going to be minus 5. All right. Well, I do think that that's it. So I guess we should give this a test here. Okay, well, that's more or less working. So there you go. You can make some minor adjustments to those values and see what happens. I'm sure you can get it to work a little smoother than that. But that is a simple way to make your infrared controller work to control a rack and pinion steering and return to center.